Come and get your love. Come and get your love. Come and get your love. Hey. What's the matter with you? Feel right. Oh, it's on.
Hello?
Hey, can I get a little bit more volume? Huh? There we go. Oh, hello, hello, hello. Well, everybody,
hello.
Welcome to the Team 4-Star MegFest panel. I am very happy to be here because I actually have, I'm going to start off this panel with something different. I'm going to start off by announcing some things. I know, right? I'm very proud to announce that. Oh, who here attended SGC or Yomacon this year? Now, do you remember a little trailer we played at those panels? Well, I am proud to announce this year we will be releasing Team 4-Star's Final Fantasy VII Machin Abridged. It will be coming out sometime this year because we're going to do something very different. We are going to write and edit a whole season of it and then release it every couple weeks. Like a proper TV show. So that whole waiting 2 months between episodes, yeah, it's not gonna really happen. It's gonna be like a 6 to 8 month wait then for a whole season. Hey, it's different, but the same as everything else. I am proud to announce that, actually, I'll make some announcements after. How would you like to see 2 minutes of it? Yeah. Now come on guys, MegFest, Friday night, you guys wanna see it? That's what I'm talking about. Okay, we'll need a volume up on that one. On the video, yeah. So do you guys like that?
Yeah.
I said you guys like that!
Yeah.
Good. I just proved some people wrong. Okay. a big thing is I will actually announce who is playing who for the first part of the show. The voice of Android 18 will be playing Tifa. Yeah. Amber Lee Connors. She didn't give me permission, so I can't say who's playing Aerith, so I don't want to. Stamper from Sleepy Cabin and from Battle Block Theater is playing Barrett, reprising his role from Pointy Bits, and he is so funny. And I am going to be playing Cloud, like Fry from Futurama. It only makes sense. That's not the only announcement I have for you guys. I have to be vague about this because we don't have enough of it done to really show you. But, no. I only look like Sasha Gray, all right? We are actually currently in the middle of producing an original show. And we actually have someone who's very talented at machinima here in this room right now who is going to be directing it and working on it with us. Have any of you ever heard of the Gmod Idiot Box? The creator, Das Boschit, is going to stand up now, and you're going to give him a round of applause, everybody. And Das is going to be working on the new series with us. And we have to be super vague about it, and I'm sorry. I want to tell you everything. But I can say one thing. One of the titular characters, the main character, will be voiced by a rice pirate. For those who are aware of his work. So that's all I can really say about that stuff. I'll play the FF7 clip at the end as well, but I guess I'm going to be opening this floor to questions. If anyone has, all right. Corinne, by all means, if you want to pick.
Okay.
Actually, I think we have the mic.
Oh,
yeah, we have a mic.
Which one of my lovely friends would like to run the mic for this?
Yeah.
Kelly was up first.
Aww.
Okay, I have to switch at the bottom.
Should have settled in Smash.
Hold on. okay. There you go. Thank you so much, Kelly. Just, we'll pick that gentleman right there in the front row with the beard. There's a lot of guys with beards in this room. You're killing the razor industry, guys. Piece by piece.
I don't have a question. I just want to say that last year, the Voice of Palooza, not like 5 feet away from where it is, to the fact that I wrote it on a flashcard, I got Alan McClain to say, you cheeky dick waffle.
You cheeky dick waffle, you. I. Wait, you were on a panel and you were supposed to pull the card out?
Yeah. Everybody got a card,
yep.
Write a little phrase on it, and they all like got distributed amongst six voice actors. Ellen McClain, her husband. I don't recognize the other two, and then John St. John. And
who got Cheeky Dick Waffle?
I wrote Cheeky Dick Waffle twice.
Did anyone get it?
Ellen McClain, the voice of GLaDOS.
I got some YouTubing to do later.
Yes, it's at the very tail end of the second part, because it's 2 hours long, and she not only does she say it, she says it operatically.
Oh.
It is glorious.
I love that woman. Thank you so much, man. That's great. I'm gonna tell Kaiser that, and Kaiser's gonna be like, no, why did they make her do that? No, they'll hate us. That's my Kaiser impression. All right, Corinne, if you'd like to ask.
She's doing the mic.
Okay.
So I only got exposed to Team 4-Star like earlier last year. Could you possibly explain why you only release one episode of Hellsinger Brinch a year?
The reason for that is because the editor is the same guy who does DBZA, and it does take a couple months to work on Hellsing because if you've seen the show, it's a lot of work.
You were just a treat.
It is not a treat for the editor. He hates it. And I get the actor's lines. Oh, no, they're a syllable too long. I got to re-lip flip. Kaiser does incredible work with that. People only knew how great his sound effect work was, because he completely created this. Yeah, no, seriously. Props to Kaiser Neko for all. There would be no series without him. But why it only happens once a year? You know, I really wish it wasn't once a year. And truthfully, and there was talk about maybe doing it two a year. But the reason why is we'd have to stop working on DBZA for like several months then. So then there'll be... that's the thing. Everyone's like, we'd prefer Hellsing though. I know, but you're the guys who go to the panels. There's only 12 episodes. Actually, I'll say this. I'm condensing episode 6 and 7 into one episode. Half of almost 90% of episode 7 is just destruction. Everyone dying randomly. People you've never heard of before. Like, no one likes those people. They're French. Seriously, they give these backstories for these characters and they die immediately. I'm like, what is this? DBZA? Come on, get these guys out of here. That was the one treat about writing season 2 of DBZA. Oh, time to introduce Goldo, get his character across, and kill him. Time to get Rakuma across, and he's dead. Okay. It's like clockwork. We had like two episodes of Dodoria, and then Dodoria's dead. Oh, such a pain in the ass. I loved it. Alrighty, Kelly.
Hi. Do you have any interest in working with the Super Best Friends anymore?
I don't know. Guys, get up. Guys, get up. Guys, get up. Guys, for a second. All right, now. Only Liam. Because he's the prettiest. But wait, you like John Cena, right? Then none of them. I can't see you, Liam. I can't. I'm looking forward to hanging out with them this weekend and doing fun stuff. Probably going to be going to their panel tomorrow and heckling them.
That'll be in my room later.
You could be my wingman any day.
Someone cued the music. Good job.
But yeah, I'd love to work with them on more. I think there needs to be more Scott Steiner. You know, Scott Steiner's not playing enough video games. For like, you got it? Oh, awesome. Thanks for watching that. All righty, Kelly, you have someone else?
Yes. Everyone loves Nappa, obviously. So my question is, I know he's pretty boring in the show, actually. What was the inspiration into making him into the character that you guys portrayed him as?
First of all, I was the most entertaining character in every single part of the show. Second of all, have you seen me? I emit joy. I am such a happy person right till the day I died. Best day ever. I realized I actually didn't introduce my I didn't introduce myself or Corinne. Oh, no, this is Megami 33.
Hi.
Megami, say what you do.
I play Bulma, Chaozu, and Puar on Dragon Ball Z Abridged. I play, thank you, I play Sir Integra Helsing for Ultimate Helsing. And I have also done my own Sailor Moon Abridged long, long ago. So, yep.
And I played a random Nazi once.
Yay!
Y'all see
Helsing? So did my boyfriend.
Okay, Helsing 5. Who are here all saw? Okay, you guys liked it, right?
Yeah.
Okay, thank God. Okay. Do you remember your line?
Yeah.
Say your line.
You scared idiots. I'm not scared of you. Look at you. You only don't. Oh, I forgot it already.
The bayonet goes on the gun, idiot.
It goes on the gun, idiot.
Professional.
There's actually a fellow cast member of Helsing as well. He's in the front row. His name is Purple Eyes WTF from None Piece. And Code Matt, get up. Wave to the people. Blow kisses to the people. Thank you. Excellent. Excellent. I'm sorry, we answered your question, right? Yes. What is your question? What? You gotta talk into the mic. You gotta put that thing right up there and just.
This is supposed to be.
Hello? Okay. Will you be doing anything further with Little Karibo?
Yes. I actually, just before. Funny story, okay. It's 2:30 in the morning, and I am just about to fall asleep for my flight in 3 hours. Then I realize I didn't record darts from Yu-Gi-Oh! Abridged. Well, I get up, I slap myself in the face a couple of times and splash water on my face as well, and I record darts at full volume. So expect more Yu-Gi-Oh! Abridged from him very soon. As for working with LK, oh yeah. Oh yeah. The one thing is I'm really bummed because you guys all know about the new Dragon Ball Z movie coming out, right? Yeah. Frieza's back. Yeah. Again? There's a shot from the movie where Vegeta's being strangled by the tail and punched in the back. I'm like, are you kidding me? The more things stay change, Vegeta, the more they stay the same. Oh no! He could never get a break even after becoming Super Saiyan. But yeah, I want that movie to happen right now because I want more Little Karibo's Frieza, which is the best. But yeah, as for anything else with LK,
I mean, it's funny when people say, like, we're going to work with LK. I think he said this in his last video, We're Here, yeah, about working. Like, we're, like, friends. Like, you know, we're buddies ever since.
That's the excuse not to pay them.
So.
You think I'm joking. It's great. Yeah, I'm joking.
I mean, I don't know my point, but just, like, he's always willing to work with, you know, just because we're buddies, you know, so we're always willing to work with projects with him.
I want him in FF7 Machina Bridge so bad. As who, I have no idea. But I want him to be in that. It's like, yeah. Anyways, all right, Kelly?
Hi.
So bright.
Hi.
It's like a solar flare out there.
So I saw you in Death Battle as Deadpool. You were really good, by the way.
Oh, thank you. You seriously have no idea how much that means to me.
Sorry if that was like the most half-hearted. Like, you were really good. No, you were really, really good. Like, I really liked it. So
that was a true pleasure to do that, because that is the closest I'll ever get to playing Deadpool in any way that matters. Because Nolan North still draws breath from his lungs.
But my question was, I saw in the comments there was like a lot of backlash from DC fans. Did you get like any of that? Like,
no.
You didn't get a whole lot of that?
No.
Well, that's good, because
besides, I wouldn't listen to them anyways. They're DC fans in 2015.
Thank you.
I love that comparisons. Like, DC's like, hey, well, we got a cinematic universe too. Really? What's happening? Ben Affleck's Batman. All right, that doesn't sound that bad. Who's playing Wonder Woman? A model? Okay, we're going to do a movie about a talking raccoon and a talking tree. And it's going to make $1 billion, bitch. Oh, how marvelous. A raccoon with guns, voiced by Academy Award winner Bradley Cooper. The future is great. Kelly.
So I'm just a bit curious with DBZA. Where did the whole idea behind the whole space Aussie theme come from?
In the original dub of Dragon Ball Z, like, I'm talking the ocean dub and the Funimation dub, they made Jace Australian.
Yeah.
And I don't know why. I honestly, and I mean this with no insult, I think they just needed it to sound different because the actor had played similar characters, and that the original actor for Jace was, of course, Scott McNeil. Now, Scott McNeil plays Duo Maxwell. He played Piccolo, and he's amazing as Piccolo. But when and half of DBZ.
Yeah.
So when they took it down to funny, they wanted to keep it consistent. So Chris Sabat ended up doing him and talking with an Australian accent. And then they did the whole Kai dub, and they're like, ah, screw it, let's do Australian again.
So they kept it consistent with having another actor play 50 roles.
All right. All right. Yeah. Yeah, it makes Brooklyn that much easier, love. But we're just like, Space Australia. Get it? But that's why like his, like, he's cousins, or he's like brothers with Salzas, who's from Space France. Anyone who has an accent is from space is from the space equivalent of it, because an accent in space, that's silly. That doesn't make any sense. That's dumb. Why are you asking what was up with that? But no, thank you, man.
Hello.
Hello.
What's up?
Going good, man. What we're doing.
Yeah.
How you guys doing? How you doing?
Good.
How you guys all doing? Who has been drinking? Who's lying about not drinking? That's what I thought.
Anyway, if you can see, my name tag says life on it, and I got 11 for you guys.
You got
Oh,
you have a letter?
11.
An entire bag of it, actually, but I can only give you one.
Wait, it's what? I'm sorry, I didn't hear.
I got a.
I have a question. What am I supposed to do with those?
Make lemonade.
There's only one man to ask that question. What to do with a lemon? No, not Cave Johnson. You know who it's supposed to be? Jameson from Spider-Man. Parker, I want you to take those lemons, put them up your ass, squeeze real hard until you make me lemonade, goddammit! Oh my.
We get to keep that?
Okay. Do I get to keep this? Are we using this for a drink, Kelly? Probably, okay.
This lemon is bitter like my ex-girlfriend.
Wow.
Front row found that funny. Okay. All right, next question.
I didn't drink enough before this.
Oh, hey, hello. What is your name, young man?
My name is Matt from Two Best Friends Play.
Oh, name drop, but continue.
I just wanted to ask, Takahata, you've often been referred to as the funny one. Is this reputation justified, sir?
I am the funny one.
That's good to know. Thank you.
I love you, Matt, man.
I'm having a blast at this convention. I just got my bags a few hours ago. Okay, a silly question. Is that the Colossus thing?
Yeah.
I thought it was everyone going Super Saiyan. I'm serious. And I'm just like, oh, man, I should do it because I totally did it as Bardock that one time. I'm done. Alrighty, what is your question?
Hi, Takahata.
Oh my god, it's Mo Chocolate from the Tester. Hi. Say everyone, hello, Mo Chocolate.
Hi. Two people know me, nice. Anyway, two things. One, you've been very adamant about how Goku would defeat Superman, and I agree with you.
I have a reason for that. All right, hear me out on this one real fast. While I love Death Battle, there's a thing I really dislike. You got to understand about the difference between Goku and the difference between Superman. Goku had one rider. Superman had like 300. So I feel as if there might be some convoluted issues with the canon of then Superman there. And when they use All-Star Superman stats, that's not fair. They should use the stats that really matter, Superman from Superman in the Animated Series. Because then Goku would kick his ass. You know what was so great about Superman in that show? He couldn't last in a fight because he would just beat up everybody. So they would start off with the fight, everyone would fly at each other, and Grundy would like punch him, and then Superman would be gone for 2 minutes of the fight. So the other characters get their fight in. And then Superman's like, oh, I'm here, and one-shots everybody because he's Superman, he's terrible.
And my second question is, may I please take a selfie with you?
Yeah.
Yes.
Get up here. Only if you hold the lemon.
Yeah.
And I hold the Sailor Moon.
This lemon.
You got my lips and eyes. I need that lemon.
you ain't taking that.
Thank you so much, Mo. Alrighty, Kelly, have you chosen another?
Yeah. Good evening.
How's it going, man? Hey. Your voice is amazing, by the way.
You can hire me if you want.
Oh, man.
even though y'all are in the middle of season two? Season three.
Season three. Yeah.
Are you currently brainstorming anything for the Boo Saga, such as you sort of have a random, I wouldn't call Nappa a random character, but in each season you had
The character who shows up who looks identical to Nappa, that if we were to abridge that, totally wouldn't be Nappa.
Yeah, Lord Guru does he just kind of walks like up. Nappa.
You know what? We're going to treat this the same way we treated Frieza. We're going to get to the end of the cell and see where we're at.
Could I make a suggestion?
You know what? Yes, you can. But however, there's a legally binding contract now. If you give me the joke and it's great and I take it, I can't credit you. Because that's how Hollywood works. And that's the Napa way. What is your joke, good sir? Deborah, what's your suggestion for Deborah? Oh, for Deborah.
Oh.
Yeah, sure. Oh, yeah.
That's right. Well, Deborah needs to sound terrifying, sir, and you sound too beautiful. I don't know.
Oh, man.
Thank you so much, man.
I just wanted to say that since the first episode, DBZ has been my favorite abridged series. How much of an undertaking was it to get so many people from different series together that had been doing other abridged series?
Actually, Corinne, like, we approached you to play Bulma.
Yeah.
And you were like, sure.
Was
it? You were like, I've never seen Dragon Ball Z, but sure, whatever.
What? No.
I'm trying to make you sound really mean in this.
I'm probably more of a Dragon Ball Z fan than you are.
Probably, actually, yeah. Really? What's Goku's name? What's Goku's Saiyan name?
Kakarot.
Oh, screwed! I didn't even know that. Dang.
What's the name of his red stick?
What?
From Dragon Ball.
Oh, so that's it's the power pull.
Took an hour, all right.
Kaiser will kick our butts. I say
that's
actually
true. No,
to properly answer your question, the actual undertaking of what it became was, you know, honestly, it would have been way more difficult if everyone involved in it wasn't as awesome as they are. Like the fact that we can contact the actors and they'll get back to us within a week. It's never been a major issue, except for like maybe once with one actor where it was hard to actually get the lines for a show. So in the end, while it has been challenging in writing, but like when it comes to actually getting all the actors to record their stuff, being a complete easy pressure because of how professional they've all been about the whole thing. So yeah, like, props to you, kid.
Yay. Squee.
That's why you're my Integra. You stuck up bitch. You're my stuck up bitch.
Aw,
shucks. I'm gonna keep punching you.
What is your question, sir?
What up, dude?
How's it going, man?
Beautiful.
I didn't see the sign because I had light blaring in my eyes.
What up, dude?
Okay. What up, dude?
Yeah, what up, dude? All right.
Nothing too much. What's up with you?
The planet's the same, but on
nice
fire.
Shirt. My mother gave me one as well like that. Stop making fun of him. Just because he has a mother that loves him, dicks, all of you.
What is your question, man?
Few things. As a voice actor, how do you manage to stay in character? Because I always find that like halfway through a line, I'll sort of like lose the voice. I'm like, damn it, I lost the voice.
I still do that, and Corinne still does that. Actor still does that.
Yeah.
The most professional even DiMaggio, any of the top-notch voiceover guys, will screw up a voice halfway through a take. In the end, in the end, you just see the final product of the perfect take, and
cool.
Not all the 10 other terrible takes.
Yeah.
Cool.
Where I hit the mic, or I hate my microphone, or I scream the F word very loud after I slur the same line the fourth time.
I understand. Also, after Dragon Ball Z, you guys are going to do Dragon Ball Bridge, right?
Tell you what, in 10 years, come back and ask that question.
Okay. Third, will you drink from this amazing flask?
Will I trade the flask?
Will you drink,
no,
for,
he wants you
drink,
to drink from
it?
I drink from the magical flask. I only drink drinks that she makes. I would. I don't know what it is, and I don't want to, and
it's
I'm totally
captain.
Not drinking anything.
Would you like the
captain? I'm drinking water.
Oh,
I'll have my court drink tester come up and test it. Doctor, yeah. Give it a test.
Let's make
no, you can't die. You're precious to me.
You.
Huh?
You're precious to all of us.
Does it taste like rainbows?
It's a.
Chug,
what? Oh,
it's the captain.
Yeah! Put that inside you.
The captain makes it happen.
No, thank you.
Alrighty, next question. Or is it yourself, your follow-up
yes.
question?
Thank you.
But thank you everyone for coming to this panel when you could be drinking instead.
We are.
That's true, I see a lot of water bottles. Alrighty, what is your question?
Okay.
Oh my God, you're dressed up as Shaggy, and I love
like,
you so
up,
much right now.
Like, what's up, dude? How you doing?
Rawr, Riggy!
Like, zoinks, dude!
Wow, that was good!
Thank you! I know it'll probably take a long time, but if you ever eventually get to Battle of the Gods... yeah, exactly.
What would Beerus' character be like?
Pretty much, yeah.
I know what I want, but I'll never get my way.
What would that
as
be?
As is most things.
Aww.
That's why I make my own show, so I get my way.
Well, would you care to share what that would be?
Oh, Goku with me, Beerus, the god of destruction. Super, what is this Super Saiyan I'm hearing all about? That sounds amazing. I'm gonna flick you, you little bug. What's pudding? Is that good? Is it yummy? I have no idea.
Okay, that is amazing. Like, thank you, dude.
If I had my way, everything would be different.
So I have to ask, how bad is Cell on your voice?
Oh, it's pretty harsh on my voice. I love it, though. Continue.
I was just going to ask, are you going to be doing Perfect Cell and Second Stage Cell?
Yes, I will be doing those as well.
Could you show us what you're going to do with the voice?
Yes. As we all know, Perfect Cell, close your eyes, everybody. Makes it better. Close your eyes. One's looking at me. I will drink you. Anyways, that's where he goes through his transformation. Cue Mario sound effect. The voice I'm going to be doing for him will be inspired by Megatron from Beast Wars. Oh, yes, Vegeta. It is so good to meet you. Oh, yes. Because the thing is, I want... And then Perfect Cell, well, in the end, you all knew what was coming. That's Perfect Cell. The reason for second form Cell is I want to take that part of Cell's voice and take the ha, and they put them together to create this voice, which sounds a little bit like this right there. Yes, Vegeta. He's very creepy. Second form Cell's even more creepy. He's like, He like licks his lips, but he's got like giant lips. And he's like 6 foot, he's like 10'2", weighs 800 pounds. He's the Big Show. Oh my God. Alrighty, next question?
Recently you transitioned from doing a bridge work to start doing more official series. How did that turn out? Did you just start dialing around, hey, I want to do voices, or did they call you and say, oh, hey, you're the guy from the Dragon Ball Z Abridged show?
I'd say most of the stuff we do, like, for example, Lanny is actually in Smite as a character. The voice of Vegeta. Yeah, he's in Smite, which is pretty awesome. Amber Lee Connors, voice of Android 18, is in Heroes of New Earth as a couple characters. I actually got to be in, who here has heard of a little game called Lethal League? I voice Raptor, the baseball bat kid. Steve Reich! Yeah, it just kind of, audition was dropped on me and I read for it. It's kind of weird. Some people contact me, they're like, hey, would you like to be in this? And I auditioned for like 40 things, book one. That is the industry though, unless you're Stephen J. Bloom. Or Troy Baker. Could you imagine if Troy Baker died? What would happen? The power vacuum would cause more death. If Troy Baker isn't in a video game, is it AAA? Makes you think. Oh, okay. Okay. Cut her off. But yeah, as for like voiceover stuff, I actually have something I can't announce for another month. Then I can talk about it. I legally can't. You won't tell. Oh, I believe every single one of you. Next question.
What's up, Tekka?
What's up?
Hello.
Oh, hey! It's Yoav the Living Tombstone!
Hey. Look how he's plugging all these names.
I like your music.
Oh, shut up. I hate your music too, but you don't make any music, so... Anyway, I love you. So, Tekka, I wanted to ask you, how do you keep your... hair so flowy, long, and black, and beautiful?
You're gonna hate me for my answer.
Give it to me.
Absolutely nothing.
Really? I have a question for you, a follow-up question for that.
Yes,
can I be like the villain from Chinese Angels movie and just cut your hair and just smell it all the time and stuff? Can I do that?
You get this much. Oh.
How about all of it? Can I do that?
No. What's up?
That was really pointless. Okay, I'll give this much.
If you produced scissors when you said that, I would have told you yes.
Oh my God.
Oh my God, I'm remembering that creepy villain from the Charlie's Angels movies. Like, what? I was so confused, and he showed up in the second movie for no reason and died.
Yeah.
I want to watch Charlie's Angels 2 now. Remember when they recast Bill Murray with Bernie Mac and hoped no one would notice? I'm like, wait a minute. Yeah, yeah, that's definitely not Bill Murray.
Okay. Hi. First thing I wanted to say is that Helsing, Abridged, is actually really important for me in as much as I was exposed to it a couple months ago, actually. And it actually helped me work up a character that got me my first voiceover job.
Whoa!
Oh, congratulations.
So, thank you.
That's awesome, man.
And secondly, as somebody who's trying to get into the industry, sort of stationed in like the Midwest in places that aren't Los Angeles, I was wondering if you could talk a little bit about making your own opportunities for voice acting.
I heard a piece of advice a long time ago, and it stuck with me. Out of any advice we've ever heard of before, the best way to get work is to make it for yourself. I'm sorry. Yeah. The best way to make work is to make it for yourself. I'm doing FF7, and I'm playing Cloud. I worked on Helsing, and I'm playing Alucard. I'm really happy to be awarded all the opportunities and make these shows that I can give other people opportunities as well to be in, because that's a personal thing I'd like to do. In the end, voiceover is very difficult. It is a very, very, it's acting, so it's very brutal. It's an industry of rejection, and you're told every day you audition that you weren't good for that. Not that you weren't good enough, you weren't good for that. It's very hard to try and like separate that. And I've actually personally dealt with that in the last year. I actually had a really big opportunity and I fumbled. I wasn't able to land it. And I beat myself up a lot. But rather than beat myself up, I decided to reinvest. I bought myself a brand new recording setup and then I booked a gig again, which is, I'm really happy about that. And in the end, I'll be able to make more stuff. In the end, everything ends at you. You are the last funnel of an idea. You either make it or you don't. In the end, you're in control of that. You could have all these reasons why you can't. Oh, it's going to be tiring. You have to do this. You have to do that. Those are reasons, not excuses. There are no excuses if you want to do something. I actually worked a 40-hour week job working in a machining shop. I would come home after 10 hours of work, have a shower, eat a Subway sandwich, and script for 6 hours on a DBZ episode, go to bed, wake up, and do it all over again. And that's what I decided to do for a couple of years, because that was my decision to make that sacrifice. There's nothing gained with nothing sacrificed. And in the end, one of the biggest things we have to sacrifice is our time. And nothing is wasted if it helped you grow as a writer, as an actor, as an entertainer. And that's the best advice I can give.
That's very nice.
Linkora got the information he needed. He's done. That's his secret. I'm gone. When's the next episode of History of Power Rangers? March, good. I'll keep watching that one with the Scottish guy.
Hi. So you guys have worked on so many different Abridged series, and you've created so many different characters with so many different basically ways of interacting. Have you ever realize that you have two characters in two different Abridged series that you really want to get in a room together and talk?
Corinne?
Not really.
Not really? So really? Bulma and Integra can't be in the room, same room together because they don't like each other?
And they're basically the same character. They're both bitchy women.
except one got laid. Air horn. I'd say I'd love to put, I'd love to put Guru in a scene with Darts from Yu-Gi-Oh! Abridged. Because I would love Guru to be the advice guy who gives advice to Darts. What should we do, man? Oh, geez, play a card game against him. But if he loses, okay, where are you going with this?
if he loses, he like dies. Do that.
Hello, guys.
Hello.
All right. Oh no, I'm all the way in the back. How did it feel to work with guys like Kyle Haber and Christopher Sabat, and how the hell did you get them?
What are you talking about? They're not in our shows.
I mean, like, because, you know, they're such...
I've met them. They're nice. Come on, dude. I told you earlier, okay?
I'm sorry, man. I can't say anything. I'm sorry, man.
Kyle Haber and Chris Sabat, oh, many of the voice actors we met from throughout who are in DBZ, the dub, fantastic guys. They're the coolest. They get it, so to speak, which is really awesome. I actually met Crispin Freeman, the voice actor of Alucard. He actually tweeted out the first episode when it came out a couple years ago. And he's like, this is the funniest thing I have ever seen. And he complimented all the actors for sounding very, very professional. And then I took a lesson with him, actually, and it was really intimidating and really interesting. And then I actually got to meet him in person, and I've never been more nervous to meet a person. Because he's scary. Because he's the voice of Alucard. And Itachi.
We talking the same thing? He's fabulous. Have you seen that coiffed hair? Like.
Yeah, I have, and I find it wanting.
Nah, you need the blonde, though. He's got, like, the blonde right there.
Bye, guys. Text me later. Oh, go get your T-shirts. Where are they available? Ah, good. Okay, moving on. They're gone now. Man, those game grumps are awesome. Anyways, moving on. All right, next question, Kelly.
All right, so I don't want Bullshit to feel left out, so I'm going to talk to him a bit. All right, first, how did it go about getting Anthony Fantano to voice Goldblum in Duke Nukem Forever Quest?
Anthony Fantano was actually kind of like, he was only at about 3,000 subscribers at the time, so getting him was kind of easy because he had actually just contacted me via my inbox and just said, like, I want to do some voice stuff, and some, like, he sent me a demo reel of about, like, 5 or 6 different voices, and he sounded great, and so I wound up with a character in the little Halloween episode, and, you know, he was small at the time. Now he's huge, and now everybody's like, how in the hell did you get that guy? I'm like, he asked.
I didn't know he blew up. I did not know that.
But Anthony's a great guy. He's fantastic. I love working with him, so he's good.
All right, cool. And what's your favorite... like mini segment to record for like the Gmod 80 box, because you know you have like Chuckles the Cheat and the Mac vs. PC. So which one is like the most fun to record for you?
Lately, the show has gotten really tough to do because there's just been a lot of like pre-planning and you know, a lot of assets I need to gather before I do things. In terms of amusing skits, yeah, I think the Mac versus PC one is probably a little like easier to do because the lines are already there and I just have to like animate it accordingly. So the Mac versus PC one is easier and probably a little more fun as well. So I'd say that's safe.
Fair enough. How much time would you say it actually takes to make a Gmod Idiot Box?
Oh my God! there is
at the what was the longest one? Because I know there's one you kept count of.
14, Idiot Box 14 was the longest one to take because I had so many technical issues with that one.
How many hours of lost progress did you have?
I had lost about 10 to 12 hours of progress.
Oh my God.
Based on some crashes. We have thunderstorm. At the time, we had thunderstorms in Florida every day. And due to the kind of, yes, I see people nodding their heads already. They know. And so, exactly. So losing power was a big threat.
And I did at one point. A model got deleted as I was animating it after I was about 7 hours into animating him. And wanted to yank my hair out. But it got to the point where I think I probably spent a total of 150 to maybe 200 hours on this episode just fixing things. So yeah, that was hard. 13 was okay. 14 nearly killed me. So.
Thank you so much for being willing to work on a brand new project with Team Four Star.
The deal with that is though, I don't have to write a thing. I just have to make what you do better. So. Oh.
That's not a shot. It's true. Have you seen his work? Come on. There you go. You're gonna have his slapstick in my writing. That's gonna be fun.
No, I do have all the respect in the world for Taka's writing, though. I'm only kidding when I say that. But you know, he's a great writer, and I really do look forward to working with the guy. It's gonna be great. I mean that. No laughing. Stop it. I'm just kidding.
It's not silly. All right, Kelly. Oh yeah. Kelly. Oh, there you are.
Hello.
This is my mind. Quiet you.
Yeah, just wanted to say, goes without saying, the show that you guys make is fantastic, and all the other stuff you guys make off that is also hilarious and creative. But talk about Dragon Ball Z Abridged. I really appreciate the fact that the minor characters get a lot of attention. One thing that I want to ask is, a lot of the minor characters, even though they're really exaggerated, are very much like they are in the show, which I think is really incredible. But then you decide to make certain characters like Popo and Guru very different. So I'm wondering what helps you decide which characters are going to kind of be more like they are in the original series and which ones are going to go in a completely different direction.
Unfortunately, luckily a lot of the original characters were meant to be more comedic, like Roshi and Krillin. Krillin is the main character of DBZ.
Agreed.
So
he is there for all of it. Goku just shows up and John Cena's the whole thing. Oh, your time is up. My time is now. No, it's so true. Goku will show up, steal someone's heat, kill the bad guy, and like, look, I won. But the reason why we like working the secondary characters for us, we like to cut away. We like to we have a scene and then we want to cut away to a different part of it so we can actually make it more of a flowing narrative. It's strange to say. I don't know. I'm pulling words out of my ass. We like cutting away because it's funny and we can be funny with other characters. And like Yajirobe and Bulma's dad are some of the most fun characters to write for. We're actually like angry. Oh, now we got to write for Piccolo again. Can we write more Yajirobe? Because the secondary characters, because they're so off to the side, you can kind of go really silly with them. Like, keep the characters consistent, but like have their conversations be funny. Like having Tien, Yamcha, and Krillin talk about, and then all of a sudden Yamcha and Krillin start getting into a one-up competition between who got screwed over by ladies more. And Yamcha won at that. But no, I really like writing for side characters, and we're entering the territory where we don't get any more. It's okay, we'll have to do a special or something. Next question.
Hey, Corinne, is there going to be more Sailor Moon Abridged?
Next question.
Oh, hell no!
I was saying boo, Ernst.
Hi.
Hello.
So, I was wondering, why do you think Goku would beat Superman in a death battle?
Why do I think
because
that?
Because Superman's power comes from the sun, whereas Goku has limited amount of power. Well, as now strong we, as he can be.
We can be very rational, but there's a boxing match going on right now.
They're settling it in Smash.
They're settling. Okay. Now, why do I think Goku could beat Superman? Because he could, okay? That is my
bet. They got very specific.
I know. They used all-star Superman stats, which count, which does not count. Maybe they should use fan fiction stats for Goku if we're going to be using that. No. They want to use 100 writers for Superman. We have to find 100 writers for Goku. We're going to fanfiction.net. We're digging deep, and we're getting the real facts. Thank you for your question, though. What, you angry at me?
Yes or no, GT is canon or not?
No.
He got a handicap and still lost.
Goku could like beat Omega Shenron with his arm tied behind his back because your time is up. My time is now. I hate that, you know? Like literally, like Gohan's about to get the rub. He's about to go over, brother. You know, he's about to kill Cell. Then Goku shows up and does a tag team move. Because Goku has to have some of the spotlight. Literally, they're fighting Bojack. And Goku just shows up and, quickly distracts Bojack for a second. And then Gohan gets the win. Oh, looks like you needed me again, huh? what are you going to do? It's me. And literally, in the second Broly movie, They're about to beat Broly, and then he shows up and kills Broly, and he's like, "Guess you guys needed my help again, huh?" I pulled out da-da-da-me. I hate Goku. I hate him. I hate how he's written. Yes, sir. You have a question.
A question and a statement. Statement. I love Dragon Ball Z Abridged, and every time I think of Vegeta, I think of the Dragon Ball Z Abridged version. Awesome. So next, I want to, you know, make content, be creative and stuff like that. I want to do little short animations, maybe reviews or just cartoons or whatever. But I hate the sound of my voice and my own mic. So I try to, you know, use other voices and different things like that. And I, you know, try and be funny and things like that. How can I be funny and, you know, like the sound of my voice, you know, in my own thing, and find a good balance?
What if I told you something truthful about myself? I actually hate the sound of my own voice. I often have even when I'm recording on my own, I try and have someone who comes in and tells me, no, that was good, you don't have to worry about it. I hate quality control on myself because I have a fragile ego and I'm a fierce director. I hate that. I'd say in the end, the best way to do it, you have to force yourself to listen to your own lines and edit them. Mm-hmm. You're just going to have to. It sucks. I hate doing it, but you have to do it because in the end, it'll actually help you as an actor or as a presenter because you hear the mistakes you're making and you'll correct them within yourself. Or you get Kaiser to do it. Now, there is a flow chart, and all roads lead to Kaiser. Are you busy?
I actually hate my own voice as well. Whenever I do a line or something like that, and like my roommate wants to watch what I'm doing, I can't sit in the same room. I have to walk out. Like, this is embarrassing. That
I feel the same way.
No, sound stupid.
Doss, you do a perfect Hank Hill impression.
Oh, thank you very much.
Oh, dude,
it's not that good.
That was a good one. Do the bois.
Huh?
Do bois. Oh, that's awesome. Like, I just want to do my Homer Simpson right now really badly, right?
Do your Homer.
Simpson, Homer Simpson, he's the greatest guy in history. From the town of Springfield, he's about to hit a chestnut tree. I wish we could do an anime dub with all the main characters from all the Fox shows. Peter Griffin, Homer Simpson, Fry, and Hank. I'll bring the propane.
You say that like he's Heisenberg.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, he will be. Bobby, we make propane and propane accessories. But Dad.
Okay, Dad.
Butterfree. I'm so sorry. What is your question?
Listen up, maggots.
Oh.
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 I've got
continue.
I've got a useless maggot here with a question. Hey guys. I just wanted to know how are you gonna have Krillin ask out 18? It's just it's been on my mind, and I kind of want to know.
That'd be spoiling a joke.
Oh man, I don't know if I can
we
handle
can't do
the
tension. That. That's either spoiling a joke or we don't have an idea for that yet. So it's we're spoiling a joke. We're gonna go with.
If I could suggest, just make it really smooth, because that's exactly who I am.
It's called manscaping. It's all smooth.
The carpets match the drapes.
Krillin goes in for bikini waxes all the time. I love doing Dead Rising. You make chainsaw. Wait.
What?
All right.
What?
Ready? Hi.
Hello.
How do I phrase this question? I love you, question mark?
Go on.
As I throw my phone on the floor. So I swear to God, I promise you I'm not asking you for a job, but I want to be in a bridge series. I'm a professional audiobook narrator already. I have a studio and stuff. But it feels like in order to get into an Abridged series, you already have to be in an Abridged series. So what do you guys look for when you're trying to find talent?
$100 on this table right now. I'm kidding. I'm kidding. Do not give me that temptation. I know me. It's like, do you want to smoke this weed? I've never smoked weed, but maybe. how do we look for people? We look for people who put themselves out there who work on their own projects and are just very dedicated to what they do. It's really hard to say. Like, we actually, for a new project, we just cast a new actor who we've really never worked with before. And for my new project, I'm casting a bunch of new actors I've never worked with before. So send me your demo reel on, if you actually are an audiobook narrator and you're booking gigs, send me your demo reel, because I can use that. All right, sounds good. Send it. You sent it to me on Twitter.
And there goes his inbox.
Yes.
All right.
Yay.
All right. So I really like the show because I've been watching DBZ for years, and it's actually got me back into DBZ. Like.
Awesome.
Like I watched the whole series like in like a few months, which is I'm not exactly proud of. But
I want it on Netflix.
That'd be awesome. But I was really excited to find that you guys were here at MAGFest, and I just want to know if there's any chance you can convince the rest of Team Four Star to try to come next or for in following years.
Oof. I'm sorry. Is Megami not enough for you?
No. I love you guys. Like, this is awesome.
But, I mean, this was kind of by accident, almost.
She was just going to attend anyways, and I talked to my network head, and like, hey, I'm going to go to the MAGFest.
I was just going
to
go have some fun, and then they're like...
Maybe, same with me. I was like, can I, do a panel there? And like, oh, I'll talk to them. And then like, okay, got your guest status. I'm like, oh, cool, okay. I really appreciate it, but it was like, as for the guys, it was almost out of convenience that we came here, because I'm actually going up to New York after this trip.
Okay.
And I'm spending a week there with my girlfriend.
Aww. That's nice.
We're gonna go to the Ghostbusters Fire Hall. And we're gonna go walk through Central Park. As for the guys, I'll can't tell them to get their asses here. Especially if they find out how easily the booze flows in this place. Scott will be so drunk. Scott is Kaiser, the voice of Trunks, and is incredibly gay.
Oh, I know.
He's so gay, he married a man.
I know.
So gay. Literally, I actually made the voice of Nail and the HBO Duquesne, the guy who plays Alexander Anderson. We're standing beside each other during Scott's wedding up in Maine, and they let Yumi now kiss the groom, and they both kiss. And I go, ha, gay! And HBO Duquesne just starts laughing, like, ha! I'll never be more proud. then we drank $400 Weiser's whiskey. I had a $30 cup of coffee.
All right, one more question. You guys sound very professional, and the editing is very professional. So, do you get job offers for like professional? Like, I know you've had some very close to actual professional gigs. But do you get job offers, or do you get people coming up to you for not just voice acting, but also for editing? For
for like any
luckily no one's come up to us for like actual needing of tech stuff because we can't spare it. Scott's time is maximized anyway already with the show, and we're already looking to like, we're actually in the process of adding more people to the team to help out with that kind of stuff. And I know for a fact we are expanding on a technical level and with a new show, actually. Like, for what you saw at FF7, Mosco X, the voice of Goku, edited all of that. He put the lip flaps on the characters. Which, by the way, if we couldn't do that, I probably wouldn't have made the show. That need, because then it looks that much better. Right? It looks that much, like, you actually really feel it like it's its own thing. If it's just voiceover over people, like, smiling, it's creepy. But yeah, no, that's and I really appreciate you noticing the tech side, because Scott spends so much time on it. He spends hundreds of hours on it. He spent like 30 hours just editing the audio of Helsing 5, just adding all the explosions, the gunshots, the swings of the sword, the walking up bloody footsteps, stuff like that. It's just crazy the amount of work he puts
in. And adding the proper amount of reverb to a certain surrounding scene. I noticed that too. It's great.
Yeah.
Yeah, no one, everyone, like, he'll change the acoustics.
Yeah.
Yeah, he'll, like, for example, like, the Ascanians, there's a bit of an echo on that line.
There's a little bit of an echo because they're in an alleyway.
Yeah. And, like,
just the little details.
Oh, God, I loved Helsing 5 so much. You guys ready for Helsing 6? Yeah. It's Saris's big episode. Yeah. I want to spoil the song I'm using. It's Cut My Life Into Pieces by Papa Roach. For those who remember the 90s. I wish I could review. I want to.
No.
You know the one I want to say.
Behave.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Your hair's pretty.
All right. Yes.
Hi, Taka.
How's it going?
I remember you.
Oh, that's good to know.
Oh my God, you got the 420 yellow swag for Jesus shirt. Turn around, show it to everybody.
I was gonna put no scope on that, but I couldn't put no scope. So I guess there was no scope.
I really wish you could have done it in the actual, you know, rainbow colors that you had it, because that would have been awesome.
We saw how much that would cost. We were like,
no!
So, Taka, bro, you're like really swole, bro.
Yeah.
What's your secret, bro?
I go to the gym 4 days a week now.
What else?
I eat protein bars after each workout, and I do very elaborate stretches.
That's it?
That's about it. I've been going for about 3 months, and now I got this.
Yeah.
Hold on. Locked, and loaded. Oh, man. Like, 8 eyes just rolled. Oh, my God.
Including me.
Rolled. I'm angry. I work my ass off, and I can't get as good looking as you.
You understand I can't answer that question, right? Because no matter what the answer is, I'm a jerk. You have trapped me with your questions, sir.
That wasn't a question. That was just a statement.
Oh, thank you. I've really been busting my butt at the gym because I want to get myself to this physical point with my having my hair as long and as luscious as it is. Like, I look back. Yep. Everything went to crap after that point. I want to have that point of, God, I look amazing. I'm fat and I'm balding. Oh, no.
Well, I am better than I used to be, because I used to be 170 pounds, which when you're 5 feet tall, that's a lot. So
that's fair. You've been going consistently, though, right?
Yes.
That's the thing. Consistency is everything.
Consistency, yeah.
If you go, and I got to suggest it, I hate them, squats. Squats.
Oh, I love squats.
My pants barely fit me anymore.
My ass looks wonderful.
Squat.
I like that person wanting. Yeah, bro, squat.
Bro. Show us the ass.
I actually had three muscle shirts. I actually had three muscle shirts that I was gonna get. One of them said Baywatch, B-A-E, watch. That's amazing, and you know it is. Second shirt was Gaston Jim. It was just Gaston, just flexing on the front of the shirt. And the last one was made of 100% boyfriend material. Wait, I canceled that one because that one was way too pretentious.
Let's see your squats results.
You want me to squat?
No. That's not. I mean, yeah.
Don't break the table.
And also, I remember you saying you were looking for some tank tops to
Tank to tops,
get.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, I actually found one that I think you might like. So
really?
I'm going to approach.
I have to see this tank top. I think you just opened up the world for an animated GIF of that top.
Yeah. Oh, that's on the internet. No.
Sun's out, guns out. Oof. I want a Dark Souls version that prays the suns, because how come the guns? Just have the sun bro be flexing. I don't know whenever I'm hopefully not drinking, which, oh, this has really been hard.
So, yeah.
Kelly's made it really hard. She's like, hey, I mixed this drink. I'm kidding, you're amazing. All right, what is your question, sir?
All right. First off, before I ask, how's it going, Megami?
I know.
All right. All right. I know you've probably been asked this at tons of cons before, but I'm just going to ask it because I'm curious. Like, clearly that Dragon Ball Z Abridged is helmed by you, Lenny, and Kaiser.
Yeah.
But, like, the three of you are all... Well, you all, when you started, you all lived in different corners of the world, like you in another country, pretty
yeah.
much.
Still live there.
So I know you've been asked this at cons before, but I'm just going to ask, how did you meet Kaiser and Lenny?
It starts off, originally everyone was doing their own separate Abridged series. And some of us still do them, actually. There's several people in this room who still make Abridged series. Isn't that right, Purple Eyes? Entertain me! Feed me comedy. We got started, I started chatting with Kaiser Neko, and we had this conversation one night. I asked him what his ideal project was, because it wasn't Lupin the Third, which he was doing at the time. It was actually originally Dragon Ball Z. I'm like, oh, why don't you do it? It's like, well, you know, at the time, Lanny Vator, Mosco X, and Vegeta 3986 were working on the movies. So I'm like, well, why don't you ask them? They like his show. They were literally big fans of his show. They were supporting a show and plugging it as often as they could. Back before there was a Twitter. Oh, wow. Holy wow. So essentially, I'm sorry, I'm just imagining a world without Twitter. It's scary.
Was there really no Twitter in 2007?
The internet came out 17 years ago, Corinne. We've only lived in the internet generation for 17 years.
Jesus.
No Twitter, we wouldn't admit.
Oh, my God.
Yes, take a picture of it.
Guys, 2005 was 10 years ago. Guys, Demon Souls came out a million years ago.
Whoa!
Guys, Hideo Kojima hasn't aged for 40 years. We actually approached Masako if we were to do the series, if he would be interested in playing Goku, and he's like, yeah. All right, that was a hard sell, but okay. Masako loves playing Goku. You can tell when he plays Goku. We approached Lanny Vator. Now, Lanny Vator was the make or break on this one because he's freakishly talented, and he's voicing Piccolo and Krillin. He's doing amazing at those characters. So we talked to him about the plan. At first, he was a little bit hesitant because he was worried because at the time, there were other Dragon Ball Z Abridged series out there, and they already gave them grief for doing the movies. And he didn't want to cause any more friction. Then he thought, wait, that's stupid. I'm in. I get to be Vegeta and I want to be a writer. And Team Four Star was born. I actually got to work with them just because I was in the room, essentially. We started scripting and we happened to have a really, 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 really good chemistry. And I got to be brought on as a writer and then Hellsing Abridged happened. Now FF7 Abridged is happening. And it was luck, I'll be honest. A lot of it was luck. A lot of everything with this was all happenstance and luck. If Little Karibo had not decided to make his Yu-Gi-Oh! Parody, none of that would have happened. Mm-hmm. Little Karibo is one of the best human beings on the planet. I owe everything to him. He's doing his new series, We're Still Here, which is fantastic. Yeah, have you seen it? It's a series about dealing with depression, and it's fantastically human. 10 minutes, and counting. Okay. Awesome.
Hello. I'm Joel, and on behalf of the Pennsylvania School of Technology Gamers Guild, can I give you a hug?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Aww. Aww. Thought you were gonna fall over there. Oh, of course. If I can get out of here.
You're stuck. Hug.
Hug him, Das. You now have to hug the people. If you go to the Institute of Technology, yeah, you have to hug everybody in this room, otherwise they feel left out. Oh, wow.
Oh.
Meg, all the bearded guys are coming out. We have to hug. That's the thing we do.
Brothers don't shake hands. Brothers gotta hug.
Whoa. Coming.
What did you start?
At the end, you only get one. All right, Kelly?
In Alucard's voice, can you say, leave the gun, take the cannoli?
Leave the gun, take the cannoli. I love the cannoli. I just watched that a month ago. Never seen The Godfather.
What is the matter with you?
Oh, I'm sorry. I watched it. I guess I should unwatch it so you could be self-righteous right now, Corinne.
I haven't seen
it.
It's
the first one's great. The second one's depressing. The third one's like, okay, it's the third one. Creepy incest stuff going on there. Jeepers. Kelly.
Hey.
Hey.
So, first off, thanks. I love Helsing Abridged. A lot.
Thank you so much.
The question I had, so the episode where you guys introduced Jan Valentine is probably one of my favorite ones.
Oh, I thought you wanted an apology. Okay, thank God. Because we got those emails. How could you? Why would you let him say those things? You know he's the bad guy, right?
One thing I wanted to know is, did you guys just decide randomly to basically take the character that he was in the old episode or the original one and basically go as off the wall as you could with him with his vulgarity just cause?
Crank him up to 11, I believe this is a trope. I was sitting there writing, like, what do I do with this guy? This guy is insane. Go that route. I had a splendid actor, Gon Xingba, the voice of Android 18 in Tien. Android 17, son of a gun. They're twins, what do you want from me? But no, he's a fantastic actor, and he killed it as Jan Valentine. He had so much fun with that. The general thing with Helsing was you want to keep it kind of close to what it was originally, because you can't go too far off the wall without it being weird. Mm-hmm. That's what you have to, and Luke Valentine comes back, and I didn't know that. So that's happening. That was the weirdest thing in the whole series. Oh, he comes out of the dead dog body. Literally, the major goes, is that Luke Valentine? Yes, it is him. And then Luke dies again. It's like, wow, being Luke is suffering.
Hey, so it's been an hour and a half, and I have a grim reminder for you. Attack on Titan. Are you going to do Abridged some more? Am I out of the loop? What happened?
I cannot legally disclose anything about that, but Attack on Titan.
Okay, a bad email or something?
I cannot disclose anything.
Can you do some sort of
I'm sorry,
Darwin's voice.
Hey, why would you want that old stinking attack on Titan Abridged when you can have Final Fantasy VII Abridged? I can't say too much about Attack on Titan. We maybe go back to it. We don't know. We'd like to, but we can't. That is the best rising it. If anyone wants more, oh my God. It'd be me. Damn, I don't want to talk so much about it. Anyways, all right, I think I have time for one more question, and then we will play the FF7 clip, and then I think we have autographs, and I have no idea where those are. Does anyone know where those are?
Just in autographs. I know where they are.
Down the stairs behind registration. We will be going down, the three of us, and Purple Eyes, if you would like to join us. And yo, we're going down signing autographs.
We can make a parade.
Let's make a parade. So, but this will be the last question, and then I'll play the FF7 clip. All right.
All right. Good evening.
Oh my God. Tell me to come on down.
Come on down, Katya. Leave your pants on. First of all, thank you for the riff tracks. You made Dragon Ball Evolution actually watchable.
Yeah.
I didn't have to give that to Goodwill. Second of all, are you going to do anything else? May I make a suggestion? Street Fighter the movie?
Oh, the Street Fighter movie.
Jean-Claude Van Damme's right over there.
We're going to kick that son of a bitch Bison's ass so hard. I miss you, Raul Julia. I miss you. I know Lanny would like to do more of them. He's like, yeah, we should do more. And they never happen. So, I mean, I would love to. I'm down for that. I like doing things that are funny. That's my favorite thing to do. But yeah, would you guys like more riff tracks from us? Good. All right, and I'm going to end it now with this clip that you've seen twice already, once already.
Okay, set the timer, then plant the bomb. And then we bounce like titties, baby.
My check for this job better not bounce. Hey, Cloud, don't do that whole planting the bomb thing. That's a bad.
Why do you?
Well, I could tell you. Bye.
What do you mean, bleh?
I heard a voice in my head just now.
What did it say?
It told me to not blow this place up.
You're making it up, and you're lying, or you crazy.
Well, okay, hold on.
Really crazy? Like, I don't trust you with the bomb crazy.
Well, then it's a good thing that I was lying.
Good. Now just do as I told you, and don't fuck up.
Shinra security breach. 4 bodies found at the Mako factory train station.
Did you fuck up?
Deploying Mako core security, death laser robot.
I might have fucked up, yes.
You can't stop us! Oh, here, I got a little present for you! Bang, 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 bang!
Time to cut this bucket of bolts down to size.
Wow.
I know. My skills are one of a kind.
Are they?
What? Not sold? Then check this out!
That will not work! That does not work!
Trust me. I was in Soldier.
Right now, that fact is scaring me. And these robots? They could literally sense fear. Yeah, there. You see, it knows I'm afraid.
Okay, fine. So, like, what should we do?
Try something different.
All right. Maybe this will work. And that's...
Yeah, you son of a bitch.
Roll.
That's how we do in the slums, baby. Okay, set the timer.
All right, guys. See you downstairs. For those who want to get downstairs.